Hey guys, Sean and I just got off the lake. It was a first day of the brand new boat, 2020. I just got it in and I wanted to show you guys and go through it. The bass tank wrap. I'm back in a wrap boat for the first time since 2011. I've avoided them since my last year on the Elite Series, so I've almost made it 10 years without wrapping a boat. This is a 920 Phoenix XP. Guys, I get this question a lot. I've been with Phoenix since 2012. Why do I run the 920 whenever they've got all the newer models out? I'm kind of an army issue guy. You guys know me. I find something that works for me really well. I started running the 920 and I love it. I'm crazy about it. The 21's great. I've had it too, but I fish a lot around boat docks and cables, and I'm always in and behind and bushes and stuff, and a foot shorter boat makes a big difference to me. The 920 is more like driving a sports car, really. It seems to react better with the hydraulic jack plate. I can get different nose positions at different speeds with different weather conditions, whether I'm going with rollers or just trying to run top end. There's a lot more to it than just running shallow water. Speaking of that, Atlas jack plate. This has been the number one jack plate that I've run since 2014. It's the only one that I've run. And ever since I put it on the back of the Phoenix, I mean, it makes such a difference in how the boat performs. I will not run one without one. I have zero issues with it. I think in the 14, I'm just trying to do the math real quick, in the 7 years or so that I've run one, 6 years that I've run one, I've never had an issue, not one single issue out of it. And I'm putting, you know, 150 hours plus on a boat. The power poles. Power poles are a must. These are the new blades. Since we've got the new trolling motors out, guys are talking about with the spot lock and stuff that they could do without a blade. I fish so shallow, I have to have them. I have to have them. I don't like stirring up the bottom stuff anytime I'm less than, you know, 6-7 foot deep. If the poles will reach, I'm using them as opposed to the spot lock on the trolling motors. We got the new Mercury 4-stroke, which came out last year, and we all had huge improvement on this motor. I couldn't believe that Mercury did what they did last year they just quit production of the 2-stroke. I mean, and the first time that I got in this and drove it, I realized why they did it. And it's a solid, strong motor, and everything about it's an improvement over the 2-strokes that we've been running in years past. So hats off to Merc for getting that done right. I'm running lithium batteries back here. It's my lithium duals that I run side by side, 36 volts, and then I'm still running. I think I usually run 3 right now. I've only got 2 in there, but they're just run parallel. AGMs. I run a third one. It's kind of my backup system. I do that a lot whenever if the lithiums were to go out, and I have had them go out. They go out a couple of times. You kill them, especially anytime you're staying on the trolling motor a lot. So running 3 AGMs there, and I use that as a backup for a 36 volt system. One of the new things that I'm really excited about this year is the new Garmin's. These are the new Eco Maps. These are 212s. One of the really cool features, instead of having to take all the knobs and stuff off these units, these things just have a little pop in the back. They disconnect and take the whole unit right off the boat. It's that simple. Well, they're on there, man, they're on there. I mean, they're locked in. But these are the new units right here. Some of the improvements and things that they've done to them is we've got some touchscreen buttons. Go ahead and put in at number 1 a graph that you've seen. Like, I'm using my maps here. Say if I'm running, and then I've got another one in my side image, and then I can just quick snap them in here to where all I gotta do is push the buttons. Really cool feature that I'm really excited about. Obviously, everything with Garmin, I can use my phone or my iPad for the Active Captain, which is a really big deal. Guys, if you guys got Garmins and you're not using Active Captain, you're missing the boat, because it's really an integral part to tying everything together with the maps, whether it be map study at night or whether it be updating your units. It's a big, big function. And I was missing it too, actually. I saw a friend of mine had a big laptop out, or not a laptop, but his big iPad in the boat one day. I was like, what are you doing with that? And he's like, oh, you're not using that on your Garmin? And I was like, no. And once I discovered that, Active Captain is a great deal. But this is a really cool feature, so we can take these units off. You can see they're clean on the back. Take these off and put them in the house at night. So if you're staying at hotels and stuff like that, it's a lot less mess than having to put these on. Take them off like the normal way. Let me just show you how quick they are. Come right over here. So there's just a little button right here. You push that lever in, pull this back, unit lifts, and it's off. It's that simple. You can take every one of these off. If you don't want them to go down the highway, bounce them back here. Take them, put them inside your pickup truck, put them in your room. And then this is what's left out here. It's just your housing and your casing. Really, really cool feature. Really cool feature. Oh, the other cool feature. The new trolling motor. Today is the first time I have run one before. We were doing some crappie fishing, but this is the first one that I've used bass fishing and had on a 920 XP. I think I could probably get my six-year-old up on skis, I think, with this thing. Dude, it's insane how strong this thing is. Like, I'm going to tear some stuff up, no doubt about it. Like, it's gonna happen. It's too fast, it's too powerful. I'm gonna tear some stuff up. I can't believe they got a trolling motor that'll pull this hard. It's extremely quiet. It's the most quiet trolling motor I've ever used. The sensitivity on the pedal seems to be great. It's an adjustment period just like any other trolling motor that I've ever used before. So definitely excited about using that this year. Live scope. This thing seems to have two extra beams that it did not have before. I've got to make a phone call about this because I'm pretty sure what I was seeing on live scope today was a little better than what I have been seeing from last year's model. So it appears to me when you look at the beams in it, like there's a couple more beams shooting down. The boat's a 920, man. I mean, it's awesome. Phoenix got new seats in it. I really digging the new seat. This is something Phoenix will do for you. So if you got a habit like me and you like to saltwater fish or, you know, inshore fish, redfish or trout, I like to go down to Port Aransas off the coast of Texas. We just got back from Galveston, Castledine, and I did. I, for years, wanted to stick my bass boat in there, and everybody says, well, you can't. Well, the reason you can't is because you can't stick our trailers in the salt. This is my second year running this trailer, so really excited about using it. And that trailer will be around long after these other trailers that we're using. I mean, there's nothing to rust. It's an I-beam of aluminum. We got the jack plate. We got the hot foot. We got the new EcoMap Garmin's 212s, 210s. The EcoMap, another thing about the Garmin EcoMap that they've done this year is with this unit's actually priced better than where our 766s or 767s and stuff were last year. They took some of the functions out of what we had because they were just kind of overloaded with salt water and stuff. So they took out a lot of the functions that we're not using in freshwater to bass fish with and kind of got this price down on this unit to where it's much more reasonable than what they have been in the past. So that's a really cool thing Garmin's doing. These units with these EcoMaps, I think you're really gonna like those. I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. It's probably EcoMap instead of EcoMap. We even close to 10 minutes? Really? Awesome. We came down to Arbuckle. This is Sean O'Brien. He's one of my high school kids that we're gonna shoot a future when we haven't done it. We were gonna do it today. We were actually scheduled to do one of the Hallman fishing matchups today. New boat in, and hadn't even been on the water. It was maiden voyage, and we already had scheduled to fish today. So we went out, and good thing we didn't, because we came down here to Arbuckle, and it's one tough nut. Water temperature still in the low, or I guess it was in 48, 49. Oh, yes, so yes. In the high 40s whenever we started today, and then it finished up in the mid 50s. But dude, really enjoyed the day with you.
Yeah.
I know it was a lot of me just tinkering around with stuff and you not getting a chance to, you know, at least you got to stand on the front trolling motor and fish most of the day. You know,
I new Garmin Force before you.
Yeah. What did you think of it?
That thing's got some power to it. It's quiet.
Yeah.
We'll get up to speed. That's for sure.
Well, I'm looking forward to our matchup. We're going to have it pretty soon. Appreciate you fishing with me today, dude.
Thanks for bringing me.
And I got a feeling you're going to be spending some time on my boat. It's a great young man to fish with. He was a pleasure today. So we're going to load up. Head back to Norman, Oklahoma. We're out of here.